Hensel and Neidhoffer, followed by Uglikowski and Essef and Sutter, which is exactly what we expected. And that fourth bike out there is the P3 of Brad Phillips.
Charlotte's Web on the infield. Is that car moving around on you? Does it stay rock stable? What's the story, man?
Well, there's a saying in Zachary Racing, say you have to drift in a three-wheel drift. You can drift a bike through their apex properly, and it's just like on this old bike. Much fun. I've got another bike down here in the gravel trap, but that Charlotte's gravel trap seems to be taking its toll here.
Charlotte's spinning her evil way. So, Larry, you know, one of the questions that I normally ask you, some of these tricky corners.
Well, I will tell you this. A Formula One sidecar on a road racetrack, on a Grand Prix road racetrack, can pull 4 G's. I can pull 4 G's on that. Here it's not so bad. You've got a short course. It's not too bad. I wouldn't think. But 4 G's is a lot. That's what a passenger can expect on a Grand Prix course overseas.
Well, 4 G's is... He's got to pull 4 times his weight, and that's what the physics are of all this. It's just something that's unbelievable, and this has been described as one of the most Johnny Kilmore likes to do. It's called lifting the chair. Can you just